Hello friends, welcome to ELS, English Literature Studies with Gaur Harpreet. Today we'll discuss Stream of Consciousness and Virginia Woolf. What is Stream of Consciousness? If you want to know that, you can check my last video, link will be provided to you in the description box. And today we'll discuss how the writers of the first half of 20th century laid emphasis on inner thought of their characters, right? And Virginia Woolf is one of them, and how Stream of Consciousness and Virginia Woolf are associated to each other, related to each other. That is my today's topic. So let's get started. Stream of consciousness. It is a style of writing or reading in which everything is unfiltered, flowing out of mind without any sort of filtration, exactly as it comes to the mind, right? And in literary context, it is a literary device most often associated with the modern movement. Modernists believe that the writers has a subjective experience. This is the belief of modern writers, that the writers has a subjective experience and the writer cannot make himself or herself fully understood to another person, right? It becomes a way of representing the subjective self. And writers of the first half of the 20th century laid emphasis on inner thoughts of their characters. For this, they used a technique of stream of consciousness, right? And these were like Henry James, then James Joyce and Virginia Woolf. Now, what does this technique mean? This technique stream of consciousness deals with the flow of ideas running in inner mind of the character without any logical reality, right? And Virginia Woolf tried this technique as a narrative device in her novel Mrs. Dalloway. It does not have a vivid plot. This novel does not have a vivid plot and real events. Mrs. Dalloway is a character who spent her time in memories and hopes, right? And that character will be discussed in another video. Today we'll discuss only about stream of consciousness and Virginia Woolf and how she introduced it in her novels, right? And then William James, he introduced this technique in his book The Principles of Psychology, that is already discussed by me in my previous video. And Virginia Woolf introduced two techniques, right? First is interior monologue and second is free indirect style in the novel. First technique, when we talk about first technique, interior monologue, it presents indirect way without using the personal pronoun I, right? And the second technique, indirect style, it was employed in the, we can see it that this technique was employed in the first line of the novel, Mrs. Dalloway. So it can be seen that the stream of consciousness is used in the novel by Virginia Woolf through the beginning itself, right? It is very clear in the first line of the novel. What is the name of the novel? Mrs. Dalloway. And this was shown by the help of time from the past to the present till the near future. And this is called a psychological time. And this time deals with the internal and the external subjectivity of each character's thought and emotions. Now, what is internal and external subjectivity? For that, you have to watch my previous video, right? And this we can say, yes, I was talking about that this is a psychological time which deals with the internal and the external subjectivity of each character's thoughts, of each character's emotions, in order to represent the flow of consciousness which is interrupted by the clock in this novel, right? And it is very clear when she said that she would buy the flowers herself, right? Now look at the words used here. She would buy the flowers herself. Right, this sentence does not explain that who is Mrs. Dalloway and when and why she buys flowers, right? The novel follows no conventional plot, and the emphasis, we can say, the emphasis laid on the manipulation of words, not on the organization of the story, right? And in this novel, Virginia Woolf has used stream of consciousness. She has mingled various thought processes of various human. And this novel shows the frustrated inner minds of every character, right? She shows the frustrated inner life of the or inner minds of the every character. दिस नॉवल वी कैन से शी हैज शोन दिस इंटरनल व्यू थ्रू दिस स्ट्रीम ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस एंड वर्जीनिया वुल्फ ट्राइज टू गो इनर माइंड्स ट्राइज टू रीड द इनर माइंड्स ऑफ एवरी करेक्टर हु आर कॉन्स्टेंटली थिंकिंग अबाउट देयर पास्ट डेज राइट एंड बाई यूजिंग दिस टेक्निक वर्जीनिया वुल्फ नॉट ओनली प्रेजेंट्स कंटिन्यूटी बिटवीन द पास्ट एंड द प्रेजेंट But she also presents continuity between the minds of the characters, right? She illustrates the relationship between exterior world and the inner world, which I have already told that internal and external subjectivity, right? She illustrates the relationship between exterior world and inner world, and the characters are shown as they're thinking about themselves or as they're thinking about others, right? These things are shown in her novel Mrs. Dalloway, right? And one cannot think Virginia Woolf's technique of stream of consciousness without switching back and forth between thoughts and the outer world, right? As a result, we can say this method provides a more authentic depiction of the characters moving forward and moving back. This method provides a more authentic depiction, and the main ideas of Mrs. Dalloway seems to be the expression of thoughts versus impression, right? And with the help of this technique, Virginia Woolf tries her best to provide a deep understanding of her characters. She strives to make us understand her characters, and she wants us to understand her characters on personal level by making them more real, right? This is the way how she has introduced stream of consciousness in her novel. And I hope you like the content. And if you like it, please hit the like button, share and subscribe my channel. And if you are new on my channel, please hit the bell button so that you can get notifications from upcoming videos. Thanks a lot for watching.